How to grow your real estate business? Probate real estate. That's our topic today. Let's get started right after this. Hi, I'm Kim Ward, certified probate real estate advisor and developer of ProbateBiz.com. Welcome back to my channel. Let's talk about how to grow your real estate business, probate real estate. When I first started into real estate, I pretty much just went into traditional real estate, and I was struggling along with everybody else trying to find clients. Then I came across an attorney who introduced a client to me, and it happened to be in probate. And that took me on a whole other path. That's when I decided I would niche myself into helping people sell homes in probate. And since then, I have spent many years developing how I do my business, and I came up with a two-prong approach, which is marketing to the PRs, personal representative, the executor or the administrator, and their attorney. There isn't a lot of repeat business typically with the PR because much of the time for my business, they do not live in my area. Now, when they do live in my area, of course, I continue to market them and stay in touch with them. And I have had some repeat business, including just this past year, I helped two brothers that I had sold their mother's home in probate. I helped them to both sell their homes so they could move out of the state. And when working with the attorney side of things, that's a whole different process. The attorneys are the first contact of many PRs. They're looking for an attorney in the area of the decedent's home. I have learned that working closely with the attorneys, in addition to marketing to them, has helped my business grow. When I say I work closely with them, I keep them informed of everything that's happening along the way, typically by email. This helps them to know me, to like me, and know that I will take care of the real estate side of the probate. That way, once the house has been taken care of, it's sold, and the proceeds have gone into an account, then the attorney can complete the probate process. And that typically takes months. And that's when they get paid. So, of course, selling the piece of real estate is a very important part of the entire probate transaction. So the first time that I thank them is when they introduce a client to me. Typically, I'll get an email or a phone call from the attorney with the PR's contact information and name. I immediately that day sit down and write a handwritten note thanking them, and I include a Starbucks card. When I first started, I would send a $5 Starbucks card, but now I send a $10 Starbucks card because I can. The next time I receive an introduction from an attorney, I might send two AMC movie tickets to them, along with a handwritten note thanking them for the introduction. After that, I may send a $50 dinner gift card to them, again with a handwritten note thanking them. That way, I stay top of the mind of the attorney, of someone who follows through and appreciates their introductions. Now, please know that I am not buying their referrals. I'm just showing my complete appreciation to them. One of my Probate Biz members recently contacted me, said that he had been talking to other real estate agents and that they were running into attorneys asking them to provide special favors, sports tickets, cash, things like that, in order to have them introduce, refer their clients to the agents. And he wondered, how did I handle that? I have had this happen. Once I had an attorney that wanted 50% of my commission in order to refer a client to me. I did not work with that attorney for two reasons. One, 50% is a ridiculous amount of money to expect to get for a referral. And two, it's a RESPA violation. That particular attorney did not have a real estate license. So I cannot give him some of my commission without violating RESPA. And I am not going to put my license on the line in order to get one client. I do work with an attorney that has a real estate license, and he and I agreed to a 10% referral fee. I'm comfortable with that. That's a fair amount for someone having introduced a client to me. Of course, it's always your decision on how you want to run your business, but be very careful. We don't want to break any rules and put our license at stake. Another thing that I do is at Thanksgiving time, a couple of days before Thanksgiving, when attorneys are still in their offices working, I will go to Costco. I pre-order holiday flower arrangements. I pick them up at Costco, and then I drive around to my attorneys who have introduced someone to me within the past year, and I thank them for that introduction, showing my gratitude. I put a little note with it, letting them know how grateful I am of their endorsement of my team and me. I choose to do this at Thanksgiving, one, for the gratitude part, and also because everybody else is doing things at Christmas time. I want to stand out in the crowded field of people giving gifts during the holidays. And back to the two-prong approach. At the end of the transaction, I send a gift to the PR, thanking them for choosing to work with me and my team. It's typically something I order from Costco, which is pretty easy to do, and I can add a note on the Costco site that goes with the gift. This is just a couple of ways that I maintain and grow my business. I hope you found this of value. If you did, thumbs up, give me a like, and subscribe to the channel. And hit that bell button to be notified of our weekly videos. If you have a question or a comment, just post it below. See you next week.